Now, in quantitative research, we start with a theory which helps us, which we're going to then try to verify and sometimes falsify, which can generally be easier than verifying. So from some sort of theoretical perspective, we then develop an hypothesis. So it's essentially a research question that we can then test. So very much an aspect of quantitative research is that it has to be a testable research question. So the research questions do tend to be narrower and more clearly defined than we would find in a qualitative study, which tends to be much more exploratory. So once we have a research question and a hypothesis, we then develop the study that would best answer that hypothesis or falsify that hypothesis, because it's easier to falsify than it is to verify. So, and that then frames our processes of developing a quantitative research study, and then we collect the data that's needed to verify or falsify the hypothesis that we've set. Now, all of this relies upon variables, and there are a range of different types of variables that we use within a quantitative study. We have what's called an independent variable. So this is the one that's going to most be affected by the study. It's the sort of the thing that we're studying. But we also have dependent variables, and these are generally the outcomes of the study. So what are dependent upon the study. Then we have what are called intervening or mediating variables, which we often can't necessarily observe, but we may know in effect. So one intervening variable is a common one is bias. We may have various biases that are impacting upon the variables of our study. And we try to minimize those biases, but we still need to take them into consideration as they exist. Then we have what are called moderating variables, which can be used to affect other variables. So, for example, if we were doing a study with different ages, we might change the language of some of our questions depending upon the age level of the subjects that we're investigating. So we would moderate things through an age-dependent variable. And then we have two other types of variables, control variables and confounding variables. So these are special types of variables that we use to try to reduce the influence of undue influence of things upon the study. But we won't go into those in any more detail. You just need to be aware that there are a range of different variables in play around a quantitative study. Because a quantitative study is very much around having a hypothesis that's directly tied to these variables. We're trying to prove things. So while in qualitative research, we're often exploring a topic, in quantitative research, we're trying to actually see whether or not something is true or not. So this should clearly relate to your ontology and epistemology. So in your understanding of what is truth and how we can understand truth, that very much frames your focus on quantitative studies or qualitative studies. If you very much believe that truth is something that exists and you can find out about and investigate and prove, then that will often lead you towards quantitative research. If you feel that truth is very much something that's socially constructed, then that may be very difficult to prove through a quantitative study. And so a qualitative study is a much more effective way of exploring and investigating a topic of research from an epistemology or an ontology where truth is more fluid.